Welcome back to part four of the Nissan Rogue detail. The last video we did correcting cream and fast correcting cream. You know, we perfected the paint or removed all the swirl marks, or at least 90 to 95% of them in the paint. This video, we're gonna be doing badges. I'm gonna show you how I do the badges. I do them by hand, and how I do the pillars and the mirror, and then show you the final results of the correcting the paint of paint correction. And then the next video will be the last video, which will be wax. So let's do it. Okay, so I'm done polishing or correcting the big panels of the car. So now we're going to go to the one part that they wanted to really make sure I got, which was right here, these scuffs and these scratches right here. And what I'm gonna use is I'm gonna use the Griot's Garage 3-inch polisher with the 2-inch Boss conversion kit. So 2-inch pad. This is a fast correcting cream pad. It's really firm. So it's something that you don't wanna just sit and dig and dig and dig into the paint, you know, really, really slow. We're gonna move slow to get these out, but we're gonna continue to move. We're not gonna stop at any point. And we'll be using fast correcting cream. I'll butter this pad up. This stuff smells like grapes. Yep, like grapes. Smells pretty good. It's gonna be hard for you to tell, maybe. That's buttered, it's white, and the pad's white, so it's hard to tell. We're gonna start out on a speed 2 to spread it. Now you're gonna notice this 3-inch polisher does not have a lot of power, so I'm hoping that this 2-inch pad conversion makes up for the lost power that this thing just doesn't have. This is supposed to allow it to rotate faster to give you more correction ability, so here we go. Yes, it's a lot of product. I buttered it up really good. All right, we're gonna move up to a 6. See what that did. If I have to, I can step up with a microfiber cutting pad. That doesn't show you either, so I'm gonna have to get the camera off. It did a really good job. Man, the light's gonna have to be perfect to see it. So right here, right in that area, it's definitely still there, but not nearly as bad. These are a lot better too. But what I think I'm gonna do I'm going to get my microfiber cutting pad for this, and we're gonna go over it again. We're just gonna do this whole rear bumper section because this has a lot of scratches in it. I'm seeing even more scratches as I'm looking at it. I can't see my screens. Hopefully it's picking it up. There's one right there. But I'll go grab that pad and be right back. All right, let's give her another shot. And this bumper was recently repainted because she did get in a rear end accident. Not a major, but it had a lot of scuffs and stuff back here, so it was repainted. Alrighty, let's do it again. I did butter this pad up really good because it's new. And microfiber cutting pads, you want to make sure you have plenty of product on here because it does get hot pretty quick. Go spread it around, speed 2. I don't know if you heard me say, but I don't go really slow with a microfiber cutting pad. I mean, it's slow, but it's not real, real slow. It does get build temperature pretty quick and can scratch if you sit there and hold it down on it. And that's about as best as that's gonna get without having paint work done on it. Looks a whole lot better. Just show you guys if I can do this without dropping you. Let's see, it's right there. Hope the camera's picking it up. Right here. But all of this looks a ton better. I've already done the whole rear of the car. I mean, it looks great. It looks amazing. You notice all this, it looks terrible. It's real dirty inside those letters. And I fought this for a long time. Never knew how to get in there. I always tried running the polisher over top of it. And that just doesn't work. Cause like, look inside this E. Look how cloudy it is. Paint all around it looks great, but look how cloudy it is. Well, I found a good way to do this. Make sure you guys can see. Yeah, you see just fine. I mean, it's an expensive tool, but trust me, it's worth having. Cotton swab. I use whatever polish I'm using, whether it's correcting cream or complete compound, complete polish, whatever. Whatever I got in my hands is what I end up doing this with. And what I'll do is I will put it like that. You see that dab right there? Hopefully. I can't see the camera very well, so hopefully it's showing. I'm gonna have to get on my knee because my tripod's right in the way. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this, and yes, I'm going to do circles. I say not to do circles all the time, and here I am doing circles. But this is the only way I've found to be able to get it spread around with a cotton swab. And it's a lot of product. And sometimes you kind of have to just force it into an area. But I'm hoping this little tip will help one of you. Because like I said, for a long time, I couldn't figure out how to make these badges look any good. But it makes a huge difference to the rear end of the car. Okay, so yes, it's still wet and there's still a lot of polish on there, but at this point I'm gonna wipe it off. The only downside to this is you do shove it in to some places that it's really hard to get your fingers. And sometimes I have to take another cotton swab, put it inside the towel, and use the cotton swab to get in and get any of that out. Sometimes I can get lucky and kind of shove just the edge of the towel in like that. Trust me, it doesn't look very good right now, but it'll look good in a minute. I couldn't tell you how many cars I've left here after I got done doing a detail, and the badge looked pretty crappy. And ever since I went and just got a cotton swab, I just one day said, you know, I wonder what cotton swab would do. It's perfect. So much better this is looking. No more haze. You do have to get it out of like the top of the letters. I'll take the dry side of the cotton swab and try to get in around all these little edges that I can't get in with my finger. Is it gonna be brand new looking? No. Now I got some left on top here, so I can just dab it. I'll go in between these letters, because honestly I don't remember if I already have, so we're going to. And then when I get done doing that, I'll show you what I'm going to do, and it makes it look really, really good. And I have done this by my fingers before in cars that have big letters. I'm going to do the letters with my fingers. I'll show you here in just a second. Okay, so now we'll wipe it off. When you first start to wipe it off, it's gonna look bad because you have a lot of product on there. It's gonna look real hazy. You just gotta keep kind of buffing it. It is a pain in the butt, but in the end, Definitely worth it. Take my microfiber towel and try to get right inside there. I probably just blocked the camera with my head. I'm sorry. What are you doing, Bubba? Nothing. You bored? She went to get drinks. Get me a new Pepsi in this 90 degree heat when I should be drinking water. Okay, so as you can see, that looks so much better. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the polish, I'll put it on my finger, and you're just gonna polish these with your finger. I have made some really crappy, hazy looking letters just shine just with my hand. No polisher, just by hand. Okay. So if any of you have ever struggled around your badges, trust me, you're not the only one. I forgot my radio was on. Hopefully somebody didn't try suing me because I have one of their songs on. I try to make all my music not have any lyrics, but I'm out in my garage working. It's okay. Like I said, is it perfect as if you just put a brand new badge on? No, but look how much better that looks. The hazing inside, the letters are all gone. You can't see, you know, where I took my polisher up to here and I took my polisher around here and then around here. It's just like it always leaves like a block of just nastiness. So there you go. There's a good tip for the day. Okay, so another thing I want to show you is doing the pillars. one of my subscribers, MTM Porsche, one of my last few videos, he asked me if I would show how I do this. So I use the 3-inch polisher with a 3-inch pad. And like I said, always make sure you tape off. Now, if the door can be opened like this right here, if this is part of the door and it can be opened, I open it and do it with the door open. This is not a part of that door, as you can see. So I'm gonna have to go up this, try to not get into here, but if I do, just gotta wipe it off, no big deal. So I'm gonna do this right here, and then I'm gonna move my way up this trim. And it's pretty simple. Show you how to do it. Cord over the shoulder. That's pretty much it. You notice I didn't do this earlier with the G21, because I didn't really want to get all the way up on this edge up in here, so I used my 3-inch on it. The only downside to not doing certain parts of the car as you're on it, like I did this fender, this door, is you have to remember to go back over that. There you go, just like that. In fact, while you're here, let's do the mirror real quick. Hopefully the garage out here, the outside light's not gonna kill me. Now, the mirrors, you gotta pay attention. There is plastic right here you don't wanna get into. There's plastic up here you don't really wanna get into. Very, very little dots. The mirror is not very big. Rookie mistake. Splattered all over the place. Oh. If you splatter, make sure you get it, because if it dries on there and you put wax over it, you're going to always see that spot. That's it. That mirror is nice and shiny now. That's how I do mirrors. And then you can also... this door trim right here, the door is right there. You can also do these the exact same way they're painted, and a lot of times you'll see that they got swirls in them. I'm gonna do them. I'm not gonna do them on camera. I'll open the door and I'll just do it like this. So I just want to point that out too. Okay, the car is not done. I still have to do the front bumper, and then we'll move on to waxing in the next video, but I wanted to get it out while the sun was out. Can't see my screen, but I hope it's picking up that pearl paint. See, the cloud's really good. Just looking it over to see if I missed any polish, like right here. Polish that I missed. I don't know if the camera's picking this up, but there's some dusting. I noticed, which I already knew this, but when you use the pad for a little bit too long, you do get some dusting. This paint looks phenomenal. It looks so good. Well, that's going to finish up this part of the series that I'm doing. I'm not sure if this is part 4, 5, 3. Honestly, I'm just shooting this ending because I'm not sure if I need it. I'm sweating my butt off, if you can see. It's hot out here. But I think in this video, what I probably showed was doing the badges on the back, the trim, the pillars. And I think I did a mirror, and then I pulled it out, took it out in the sun so you can see what it looks like. That's what I always do. Even though I have that nice light, I still pull it out in the sun, make sure that I don't see any polish left on the car. I did. I got it off there, went over the whole car with pre-wax cleanser, pulled it back out. Looks great. Next video is going to be waxing, and we will just have to take it from there. So if you like this video, give us a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button while you're down there. And if you've never been on this channel before, this type of videos we make, detailing videos, and my videos are starting to get, in my opinion, better as I go along. I've been making videos since January, so hit that subscribe button. And we can all just take this journey together, and we will see you in the final video.